As water costs continue to rise and more restrictions are put into place, the need for irrigation systems to be as efficient as possible is more important than ever. When a system doesn't distribute water evenly across the zone, you can end up with areas that are either overwatered or underwatered. In an attempt to remedy this situation, the user will typically either increase or decrease the runtime of the zone. But this doesn't really solve the problem. In order to address the problem properly, an irrigation audit should be performed. An irrigation audit is a fairly simple process and provides a lot of useful information that can be used to make your system more efficient. To perform the audit, you will need a few items, including an irrigation audit worksheet, marking flags to identify the sprinkler head locations, a measuring tape to measure head spacing, a pressure gauge and adapter to test the pressure at the head, a stopwatch, and a minimum of 24 catchment cans with milliliter measurement increments. To begin, turn on the zone to be audited. Mark the locations of the sprinklers and note any that need repair or adjustment. You'll want to take the time to make any repairs or adjustments before proceeding. Also, take note of the nozzle brand and model for each head, including its arc and radius. After making sure that the system is hydraulically sound, lay out your catchments. These should be placed in a grid pattern within the zone. When auditing spray heads, catchments are placed at each head and halfway between each head. If any catchments are blocking the spray, you will need to lower or move the catchment. A minimum of 24 catchments must be used, and the total number of catchments needs to be divisible by 4. Before starting the actual audit, draw a map of the zone, including the size and shape of the area. Mark the location of each sprinkler head and the nozzle used, as well as the location of the catchments. Also, measure and record the distance between the spray heads. Next, attach a pressure gauge adapter and pressure gauge to the furthest head from the valve. The adapter is installed between the nozzle and the stem. Now you're ready to begin the audit. Start your timer as you turn on the zone. While the zone is running, record the pressure reading on the gauge. Continue to run the zone until there is an average of about 25 milliliters in each catchment, then turn off the zone, stop your timer, and record the time. Next, record the amount of water collected in each catchment, reading from the bottom line of the meniscus. After all catchment levels have been recorded, you're ready to determine the efficiency of your sprinkler zone. Sprinkler efficiency is typically measured in terms of DULQ, or distribution uniformity, low quarter. To calculate this, add up the total amount of water collected in the catchments. Then divide the result by the number of catchments to get the average amount of water collected in each catchment. On your audit worksheet, identify and circle the 25% of the catchments that collected the least amount of water, regardless of where they occurred in the zone. In our example, we used 24 catchments, so we've circled the 6 catchments with the lowest amounts of water. Add the total amount of water collected in the 6 catchments, then divide the total by 6 to get the average for the lowest 25% of the catchments. Finally, divide the average from the low quarter catchments by the average from all of the catchments to determine the DULQ of the audited zone. Spray heads with traditional nozzles typically have a DU of about 40 to 45%. Spray heads with high efficiency nozzles and rotors typically have DUs of about 70%. The higher the number, the more efficient your sprinkler system is. Now, audit results may vary from site to site based on the type of nozzles used, the head spacing, and the operating pressure. The information gathered from an irrigation audit can be used in several ways to improve the efficiency of your sprinkler zone. Looking at your map and the catchment readings, you might have found areas that are receiving either too much or too little water. To correct the issue, you may need to install or move a head. The solution could be as easy as installing a new nozzle with a larger radius. Or if you have a mixture of different types of heads and nozzles, changing them all to the same brand and model could help to improve the efficiency of the entire zone. In some cases, the best way to increase the system's efficiency is as simple as replacing the existing nozzles with one of several high-efficiency nozzle options. The MP Rotator from Hunter is a great example. These nozzles have the same precipitation rate across all arcs and radii, which provides more even water distribution than a standard spray nozzle. This typically has a significant effect on the efficiency of the whole system and can raise the DU to as high as 70 to 75%. If you're interested in becoming a certified landscape irrigation auditor, contact the Irrigation Association for more information. The products used during this audit can be found at your local Ewing branch. For locations or to shop online, visit us at ewingirrigation.com.